How are you supposed to properly design a huge network of pipes? I mean, sometimes there can literally be billions of combinations, and there's no way you as a time-deficient engineer have time to run through them all. So like most people, you probably resort to heuristics, manager experience, project experience, what have you. Well, we suggest you ditch those archaic ways of sizing and you step into the 21st century of automated sizing using numerical methods to find the proper size for your network of pipes. And that's exactly what I'm showing you today, automated network sizing. And it's a brand new add-on module for AFT Fathom and AFT Aero programs. And with it, you're going to avoid deadline-driven compromise. You're going to edge out your competition and you're going to design intelligently. So let me give you a quick walkthrough of exactly what I'm talking about. So for example, we have a cooling water system right here. And according to the demand required through the heat exchangers, all of these pipes were sized, you know, accordingly. And according to the previous engineering done, this pipe here, P9, was originally sized to be 14 inches. And I want you to pay attention to that size and that pipe, because at the end we're going to show some comparison. Now, the beauty of using automated network sizing is that you don't just size for one pipe. Anyone can do that. It's about looking at the system as a whole and using cost minimization methods to find the best size as a network, again, not just a single pipe, but as a network. So I just pulled one out for example here. So as soon as we go to this sizing tab, what I want to do is minimize my pipe weight, the whole weight of the system as an initial cost estimate. Great. Okay, so then we move on to the sizing assignments. What we call common size groups are intuitive to you. You would expect that in and out of a heat exchanger or the suction and discharge side of a pump ought to be the same size. Well, that's exactly what we've got here. Already set those up, easy as that. Okay, next step is that we need a candidate set. We need to tell the software what to choose from. And you know, I have no idea what size those pipes should be, so I have the options of 1 inch all the way through 36 inches. Just throwing it out there, why not? Of course, this design has to be tied down by something. That's what we call design requirements. This is the bread and butter of everything. This is the fence around your yard. This tells the software what is a good design or not. You have a maximum velocity in the pipe, a minimum pressure. For your pump, you have a net positive suction head margin to avoid cavitation. Control valve, you've got minimum of 5 PSI pressure drop across the valve to maintain good control. Last thing, I choose what kind of sizing method I want. I want discrete because I want to use only commercially available sizes. Boom, run the model, and in a matter of seconds, we've run through hundreds of designs to come up with the best one. So again, not only have we met all the pipe requirements, pump requirements, control valve requirements, we actually minimize the cost of this whole system while simultaneously meeting those requirements. So P9, remember what I told you to pay attention to before, originally 14 inch, bam, can actually be 10 inches and get you the same duty through the heat exchangers and meet all of your other design requirements. And check this out, the whole system used to weigh 190,000 pounds. Now it weighs just 176,000 pounds. That's a weight savings of 14,000 pounds, which translates directly into money. And at a minimum, you saved your installers some extra heavy lifting. So that's ANS for you. If you are interested or would like to learn more, we'd love to help you out. Give us a call at 719-686-1000 or contact us via email below, info@aft.com. Hope to hear from you soon, and happy engineering.